There is a chasm, a split in the Democrat Party. It is a fight in New York City between hard left politicians and moderate Democrats. The fight is over Amazon's headquarters, the second headquarters that was supposed to be built in Queens, New York. Amazon hasn't bought the property for it yet. Amazon getting pushback on the tax breaks it's gotten. Also, unionization push for Amazon there. Look at this. Chicago and Illinois apparently reached out to Amazon saying, hey, come on over to us. Build your second headquarters here. We want those 25,000 high-paying jobs that go along with it. That's exactly what Democrat New York Governor Andrew Cuomo warned to the hard left, saying, hey, hard left, stop being habitually self-deceiving. Your reality check bounced a long time ago. You're going to ruin it for all New Yorkers. Watch.
We had 234 cities that competed for this. This was the grand prize from an economic development point of view.
Let's bring in, for his expertise, Fox News contributor Adam Leshinsky. He's also the author of this great book, Wild Ride. He's a Fortune executive editor. Adam, you know, your take on this Amazon fight between the Democrats.
Well, and you should have mentioned a native Chicagoan, so even though I've been gone a long time, I'm a little bit biased here. Liz, I think Andrew Cuomo is exactly right. I mean, there are reasons to reject a company like Amazon, saying that the tax breaks they're asking for are too great. But those reasons ought to be really, really strong, because the economic benefit that they're going to bring to a city like New York, or Chicago, by the way, also a very blue, also very Democratic city, are just immense.
Yeah, you know, in Chicago and Illinois, we know that they have a severe deficit, insolvency, you know, pension crisis there. We're talking $3.75 billion in total annual average salary payouts by Amazon. The tax breaks are $2.8 billion over a 10-year period. Even the left-leaning Washington Post, Richard Cohen, in an op-ed for the Washington Post, said, New York Democrats, you're wrong to block Amazon. Here's the quote. It's based on an antipathy toward capitalism that is rampant on the left. If these people get their way, Amazon will simply go elsewhere. Ocasio-Cortez, she's basically going to stay there, given her genius for publicity. She's not going to go elsewhere. What's your take on that?
Well, I don't know if it's I think these things tend to be emotional. So people are various people, not just what you call the hard left, are emotional about Amazon. And so I understand people being emotional. But, you know, there's a Britishism I love, which is the knock-on effect. The knock-on effect of an Amazon job in a place like Chicago or Queens is massive, whether it's whether it's times two or times three or something in there. Common sense tells you that if you give somebody a job in Queens or Chicago, that several other people, like their family members, the people they buy things from, are going to benefit from that knock-on effect.
Yeah, because there's more economic growth and other companies come in to build from that halo effect. You know, you can feel and understand the sympathy and sympathize with the idea of corporate welfare and tax breaks. But the reality is, we had 230 cities, more than 230 cities, Adam, saying, hey, come to us. We'll give you tax breaks. And we've got companies like Boeing, Nike, General Motors, Tesla, Adam. They got $1 billion in tax breaks from cities, too. I mean, we get it. We understand the corporate welfare angle. But, hey, the real world is saying cities are doing it. Come to us. We're going to give you tax breaks, right?
I think these trends, they travel in packs, if you will. So for a while, cities gave sports teams massive tax breaks to build their stadiums. It was a good idea in some cases. It was a terrible idea in others. And then that went out of vogue. You know, a few cities, I can't remember who said, you know, we're not going to do that anymore. Take your team someplace else. And they were right to stand up to these teams. And that's not what's happening by and large with these cities right now. They're recognizing they need these companies. They want these companies, especially really high quality companies like Amazon, which, you know, again, common sense tells you that no matter how long the tax breaks last, that Amazon, if it puts 25,000 people in a new quote-unquote regional headquarters, that it's going to be there for a really long time.
Yeah, it's a good point, Adam. But, you know, it's so interesting. This Amazon story is sort of a portrait in miniature, of the split of what's going on in the Democrat Party. Adam Leshinsky, you're great. Come back soon. Thank you so much.
Thank you.